Well, it was in the winter of 1859. The Danish king, Frederick II, liked to stay at Frederiksborg. And unfortunately, the castle wasn't really ready for having royal guests in the winter. And unfortunately, a fire had been made in the fireplace, and the fireplace wasn't really ready for it yet. It wasn't really finished. When smoke was beginning to show, nobody dared go into this room. They had to have permission for getting the key. It took a long time, and before they managed this, it was too late. The fire destroyed most of the interiors of the castle. The paintings were lost. And Bure Jacobsen, he took it into his heart to make sure that Frederiksborg was reconstructed. He said, we need to have new paintings. They need to be on copper plates. He ordered these made from one of the most outstanding Danish artists at his day, Carl Bloch. The paintings of Carl Bloch have never left the castle since they were placed here in the 1870s. And it's very difficult to get permission to get them out of Frederiksborg because they are an integrated part of the castle. And the reason why we do this very extraordinary loan is that we want to respect the love that many people in especially Utah have for this Danish artist. But still, it is extraordinary, and I don't believe it will ever happen again.
This show will include three artists: Carl Bloch, Heinrich Hoffmann, a German artist, and also introducing the artist Franz Schwartz.
We've taken this idea of sacred gifts, and we want to explore and celebrate the many gifts that are represented in this exhibition.
Jeres udstilling hedder Hellige Gaver. Og hellige gaver kan være så mange ting.
Our congregation think it's very exciting that someone else is interested in a picture we have in our church.
I think the painting will be a gift at the exhibition because the value of it is a beautiful thing. It makes me happy that other people could see it.
I hope that the public will be moved by the expressions.
Every time I'm in this room, it's a gift to me. Every time I look at it.
It's a great gift that our picture can go far away. It has a duty to do somewhere else. And we hope it also will be a gift for you to have it.
I 1902, der var der en brand her i kirken. Det var et af alterlysene, der forårsagede det. Da lysene var tændt, og den kirketjener, der passede kirken, havde forladt kirken, og da hun kom tilbage, så var der gået ild i et tæppe. Og den store og meget smukke altertavle, der var et træskærarbejde, kunne ikke reddes, men gik op i flammer. Efter at det gamle alter, den gamle træskære altertavle var brændt ned, så kontaktede man en maler, Franz Schwartz.
Franz Schwartz was independently wealthy, and so he didn't have to sell his paintings in order to make a comfortable living for himself. He was very generous, very kind, and so quite often he would donate his religious paintings to the churches.
Mit Beginn des Krieges 1939 wurde auch die Gemäldegalerie geschlossen und die Bilder wurden zunächst in Depots in Dresden eingelagert. Die Gemäldegalerie im Zuge der Ereignisse des Krieges und nach dem Krieg insgesamt 450 Gemälde noch heute vermissen und 201 Gemälde zerstört wurden. Die Gemälde von Hofmann haben Krieg fast unbeschadet überstanden. Sehr interessant ist natürlich auch, dass 4 Bilder von Heinrich Hofmann in der Riverside Church in New York sich befinden, geschenkt von Rockefeller Jr.
Riverside is certainly proud to be the owner of these historic paintings. This entire building is a part of an immense gift from the Rockefeller family.
This building, the paintings, all of their generosity to this church and the world is coming from a good place. They've blessed us with something that now can go out into the world and be a blessing to other people.
People worshiping Christ can always find something in common.
I'm thrilled that we are reaching out to other people who may believe a bit differently than we do.
We know that we are a lot of brothers and sisters. We are commuting and connecting at one very specific point, and that is the celebration of Jesus Christ.
I'm a child of God. I am. And that idea is really important.
I think that these altarpieces can give people a sight of Jesus as a person and as God, to see his face, to know his care for all the people that are coming to him, and maybe find it in their own heart too.
That's exciting. I've got chills.